Hello students, I hope you have understood my last chapter, that is mineral resources. Today I'm going to discuss another chapter from your syllabus, that is chapter number 13, conventional source of energy. As this chapter is very long, I've divided this chapter into three parts: part 1, part 2 and part 3. Part 1, it consists of coal. Here I'm going to discuss about coal. Now, what is conventional source of energy? First of all, conventional source of energy, you may also called it as non-renewable source of energy, means the sources of energy which cannot be renewed once it is used. Source of energy which cannot be used once it is used or finished. Or it is the source of energy which are being used by man for a long time and are still being tapped and used abundantly. It's a source of energy which are being used by man for a long time and are still being tapped and used abundantly. Coal, it is a combustible solid stratified rock of organic and mineral matter. This coal, it is a combustible solid stratified rock of organic and mineral matter. It is composed of 60 to 90% carbon, 1 to 3% nitrogen, 1 to 12% hydrogen and 2 to 20% of oxygen. Generally, coal occurs as sedimentary rock. Depending on the amount of carbon, moisture and volatile matter, coal can be divided into three varieties. They are, number one, anthracite. It is the hardest and the best quality of coal. It is shiny and lustrous. It looks black in color. It has 90% of carbon content and burns without any smoke and leaves behind very little ash. Anthracite coal, it has 90% carbon content, burns without smoke and left very little amount of ash after burning. Bituminous coal, it is hard, black and compact, makes of the world's total output. It is used as a coking coal. Lignite, it is also known as brown coal, as it looks brown in color, is the low grade coal and it contains only 40% of carbon. Peat, it represents the first stage of transformation of wood into coal. It has least carbon content. It is the first stage of transformation of wood into coal. It has least carbon content. Now, how wood is transformed into coal? So, decomposed wood, when it is decomposing for a longer period of time, after a certain period, it converts into coal. Distribution and use of different varieties of coal in India. Anthracite, it is found in the state of Jammu and Kashmir only. It is ideal for domestic use as it is a smokeless fuel. It is used for metallurgical process in iron and steel industry. Bituminous coal, it is mainly found in the Gondwana coal fields in the peninsular region of India. It is used to produce coke and coal gas. High-grade bituminous coal is used for domestic purposes. Lignite, it is found in the states of Tamil Nadu, Rajasthan, West Bengal, Kerala and Puducherry. Lignite, it is used for the generation of electricity. Peat, it occurs in the Nilgiri Mountains in patches in Kashmir Valley and swampy areas of coastal plains. Now, distribution again. India ranks third in the world after China and USA in coal production. The oldest coal field in India is in Raniganj in West Bengal, and the largest coal field in India is located in Jharia in Jharkhand. In India, coal occurs in rock sequence mainly of two geological ages, namely Gondwana coalfields and Tertiary coalfields. Gondwana coalfields are those which are formed over 200 million years ago, and Tertiary coalfields are those which are formed about 55 million years ago. India does not have the highest grade of coal. India mainly have bituminous quality of coal. Now, the advantages and disadvantages of coal. First of all, advantages. It is used as a source of power. What? It is used as a source of power for running machines in industries, train, ships, etc. It is used for manufacturing of iron and steel. It is used as a source of direct heat and energy for domestic purposes. And variety of chemicals such as ammonia and benzol are obtained as byproduct from coal. Now the disadvantages. Calorific value of coal found in India is very low. Production and transportation cost is high. Production of coal and transportation of coal field, transportation of coal from the coal field is very high. Limited reserves of coal. There are limited reserves of coal in India. Next, number four, that is pollution. Coal, it causes a large scale pollution at the site of mining and place of use, because when coal is burned, it releases carbon. Now, as I told you earlier, in India we find two types of coal fields, Gondwana coal fields and Tertiary coal fields. First of all, Gondwana coal fields, it account for 98% of coal in India. It is free from moisture and contains sulfur and phosphorus. Gondwana coal fields are mostly found in the river valleys of Damodar, Mahanadi and Godavari. And also in the states of West Bengal, Odisha, Madhya Pradesh, Uttar Pradesh, etc. As you can see in the given map in your left hand side. Next, Tertiary coal field. The coal that is found in Tertiary coal field, that there has a high moisture content, more sulfur and are associated with marine sediments. They are mostly found in the northeastern states of Arunachal Pradesh, Meghalaya and Nagaland. The Neyveli lignite field in Tamil Nadu is the largest lignite deposit in India. The Neyveli lignite field in Tamil Nadu is the largest lignite deposit in India. That's all from coal. Thank you.